Calendly versus Cal.com. Which scheduling tool works best for you as a Webflow user? Today, we're going to explore both tools and how they embed or how they can be implemented on your Webflow site. Now, I've personally used both and I've implemented them on many of my clients' websites. And by the end of this episode, I'm going to share with you which one is my personal favorite because of how much we can customize it on Webflow. But in this episode, we're going to go over both tools one by one. We're going to start with Calendly and then we're going to go into Cal.com. So let's have a look into these tools. Now, we're starting with Calendly. Now, Calendly is one of the first scheduling tools out there. It's been around since 2013 and it's well known by big clients and big companies. It's famous and we can say it's one of the market leaders when it comes to scheduling tools. So how it works is that they give you this calendar, you get a link with this calendar, people can book calls with you. You can synchronize this with your existing calendars like Google Calendar or Outlook so that it synchronizes in the sense of availability and the time blocked. Of course, you get more features like payments, email automation, and embedding on a website. Now, both these tools have pricing plans and they have different features based on different pricings, of course. But in this video, we're only going to focus on the free plans and how much we can get out of the free plan from Calendly. So let's start by making an account. Now, I already have an account. If you're following along, pause this, create an account, and let's continue. So I go to my account. As you can see, I have my dashboard here, and then I have my booking meetings. Now, since I'm on the free plan, I can only have one of those. And this is something that is different on cal.com, but we'll explore that later. But in the free plan, you can only get one meeting, one meeting link. We're going to embed this on the website. I think this is here. In this settings, so here we can go to add to website, and then here we get these three options. Now we're going to explore three of them. Again, I'm going to leave timestamps in the description so you guys can skip to the part that you want, but let's start with this. So we're starting with inline embed. So we select it, click continue. They give us this script, this embed code. Now to customize this, I need to upgrade, and you get a couple of options here for cookies and page details. Now I can click here and say copy code. And then I go to my Webflow project. Now I have this landing page where I'm going to embed the options here. So here I want to embed an inline calendar. So I go to embed and then I paste in the script they gave me. I get this embed. And because this is JavaScript, I need to publish to see the actual embed. So as we are published now, we can go to the website. I can scroll down. It's loading. You can see it has this Calendly. And click on the meeting and loads, you get the calendar, you can book the time, and that works fine. Now let's say I want the calendar to load with this opened, with this call opened, so it's directly a calendar. We're going to go back to Calendly and we're going to view booking page. So this is the page that we want. We're going to copy this URL from before this question mark sign. So I'm going to copy this and go back to my code. And then I will paste it instead of this URL. And then I will save and close and publish. Now, as you can see, if I go back to my site, it's already parsing in the page with this 30-minute consultation call that I already set up without me having to go through that extra click. So this is something that you guys can do. Now, let's go through the other options that Calendly give us. So let's go back to add to website. Let's try the pop-up widget. Now, the pop-up widget is a button that's basically something like this. And then when you click on it, you get the calendar as a pop-up in a model. This you can customize. So you can customize the button color. We can make it yellow, for example, and the text be white or black. And further customization needs some upgrade. So let's copy this code. Again, we can just click here, copy, go back, and I'm going to add it here. And I'm going to add an embed, and I'm going to paste in this code. Click save. And then I'm going to publish. So now if we go back to the site, we refresh, we get this button here, schedule a time with me, click on it, you get this pop. It's overlapping with my maiden Webflow. So this is something that perhaps we need to look into when we want to position this on the page. Simple, very straightforward. Now let's go back to Calendly and explore the last option that we have, which is add to website, which is pop-up text. So let's see this one. Now this one is something that we can at least customize a little bit on Webflow. So we can select the code, we can go back to our page and we can paste in an embed. So if I go embed, I paste in the code like that. And you can see that this is the text that's gonna come and it's gonna be a link. On click, it opens this widget. So if I save and return and I publish the site, let's see how this looks like. Now if I go back to my site, I can see this text here. If I click on it, I get the same pop-up that I get from here. Now I can style this a little bit. Say I want to add some styling like the button. So if I see my button, if I add a button here and I give it the class of button, you see it has some styles preset. So I'm gonna copy this class and I'm gonna delete the button. I'm gonna go to my custom code, the embed, and where it says A, so that's the link text that we just saw, I'm gonna add a class. So it's gonna be class and it's gonna equal button class that we already have on our workflow project. I'm gonna save and close, I'll publish, and you can see this text now starts taking shape of the button styles that we have. So if we refresh, you can see it has the same shape as the button, even the hover animation. However, if my buttons get too complicated with icons and graphics inside them, this might be a bit more complex and you might need to add more to the code. And that's it for Calendly. Now they offer us these three options only. And to customize this further, like we saw, we can change the URL destination so that it opens a specific meeting page, or we can add some classes, change some colors, and do simple things that can help us adapt these embeds on our website. If you're liking this type of content, do subscribe to the channel, do give this video a thumbs up, and do give us thanks now that we have that feature online. The more support you guys can give us, the better content we can make, the more content we can make, so to give thanks. Now let's get back to it. So let's explore cal.com. Now, similar to Calendly and other scheduling tools, cal.com provides you with a link where you get a calendar, schedule calendar like this. People can go in and schedule a time with you based on the availability that you set up, or you can connect your digital calendars like Google Calendar or Outlook so that it synchronizes and shows the correct slots. Now, cal.com is an open source program, so you can see how your data is being handled, and they have also different pricing options. However, on cal.com, on the free option, you get a lot more, like many different scheduling links, receiving payments, connecting your PayPal or Stripe, and other features. Let's explore how this embeds on our Webflow site. Now again, if you're following along, you need to create an account and sign up. So I already created an account so I can go to my app. So this is my dashboard. Now I have some meeting links set up and I want to embed this Say Hello on my website. Now, as you can see, I have already connected Stripe so I can take payments on this. I've already set it up on my availability. Then we can go on the menu here. We can go to embed and we can look at the options that we have. So let's try the inline embed. Now in the inline embed, you get this code right here, you get the script, you see a preview of the embed that you're gonna have. You can set the brand colors, but in my case, I don't know, that never seemed to actually work. I'm not sure which element should color, but apart from that, you can set weekly, monthly, however you want to view this. So let's go with month, and you can set the theme to be auto, dark, light, and the window sizing. We can set these to auto later on if we have specific customization. So let's copy this link. Also, you can copy code from here that is similar to Calendly. Let's go to our project. Now this is the cal.com page and we want to embed the calendar here. Let's get an embed element and we paste this right here. We save and close and we publish to see our embed. Now that is published, we can go to the site and it's loading. You can see the embed right here. And this is very nice. It's a bit long, so maybe we can adjust the height from the code. So since the height was 100%, perhaps we can make it into 50% and we can overflow scroll so we can scroll through that section. And of course, this is something that you can customize based on your design. And we can also customize the destination. So this is taking me directly to the hello page. And if I wanted to take me to the main page with all the links, just like this one, I can just remove hello and keep my username or the slug that I'm using for my account. So in this case, the users can choose which meeting they want to book. Let's have a look at the other embeds that cal.com provides. So let's close this one and let's go back to embed. This time there is a floating pop-up button. And this is similar to Calendly, where you have that floating button similar to this. You click on it and it brings up the calendar in a pop-up model, so we can copy this code and try it out here. So let's get an embed and paste it in, save and close. Of course, now the button comes in black. You can customize it from here, say red or white text. This is up to you. So this is how it's gonna look like. So if you click on it, you get this model. Let's have a look at the next option that cal.com provides for us, and this is a pop-up via element click. So this is the one that I like the most because this gives me total autonomy on my button and how it looks like. So what this allows me to do is create my own element, give it some attributes, and this element will open that pop-up model. So let's copy the code and let's see how that works. So here I'm gonna add a button and I'm gonna name it button class, and then I will just center this. So I wanna center, and I'm gonna center everything, and this will be book call. And then this button will have some attributes that we can get from the code right here. So we have these three attributes that we need to add. So I'm gonna copy them and add them on my Webflow project. So you go to a custom attribute, you add data cal link, and this will be this link here. So just to point out, the cal.com script gives you this in the double quotation mark, and Webflow custom attributes, the value doesn't allow you to put double quotation marks, so you can change that to just a single quotation mark and that will solve the problem. Now let's go back to the code and we need to copy this entire embed. So let's paste this in our project setting, and we can delete this part with the attribute since we already set those up. We can save, can publish and see how this works out. So now that we published, we can see how this looks. So we have this button and we click on it. We have the embed right here. Now this is great because I'm using a button from Webflow and then I can style however I want and add how many elements I want. This can be a link, this can be a button, this can be a div block, this can be anything. Perhaps if I want to reuse this, I can create this as a component and I can call this button book call. And this component will have the attributes with it. So wherever I paste it, if I paste it here, a component, it's already there with the correct attributes. Now, if we have a look at the two different versions, you can see the differences. So this is the inline embed, and this one, it's actually much more stylish. The schedule is the same. This button is also doing the same thing. However, since this is done with attributes instead of a custom class added in the embed, this would be much more efficient and much more accessible friendly. Then we have this floating button, and you can see with cal.com you just get this icon, and Calendly you just get the text and a normal button floating here. My personal favorite is of course cal.com because I can have payments on my calendar links without having to get a subscription. I can do that on the free plan. Of course I pay the fees from Stripe. However, I don't need to pay for a plan monthly that just allows me to just make this integration. So cal.com is definitely my favorite. Again, with the button connected with attributes, this gives me freedom to make the experience very smooth, very nice, and fits my theme. So thank you for watching this video. I hope I taught you guys something today. This video is video 22 of the 100 days of Webflow journey. Now I know this journey is not being done daily, but there will be 100 videos with a lot of content that you guys are going to enjoy, you guys are going to make a lot of use of, and we're going to see you tomorrow in episode 23.